Hi folks, Ice Team Pro Tim Moore here. It is April 1st. This is no April Fool's joke. Ice fishing season is over here on Lake Winnipesaukee in New Hampshire, officially and unofficially. We lost our safe ice almost 2 weeks ago, and yesterday was the last day to ice fish on the lake. Today's opening day of open water season, and I thought I'd walk you through some of the steps that I take to put my gear away. So the first thing I do when I am putting my gear away is set up my shelters and get them aired out and dried out. If there's any moisture left in these shelters when you put them away, you could trap a lot of moisture between the folds where things close up. Maybe there's not a lot of airflow where you store your shelters. There certainly isn't where I store mine in my snowmobile trailer. It's pretty tight. Gonna wanna make sure everything's dried out so there's no corrosion, there's no mildew, no insects, anything like that. And an important thing for me, whether it's my X300 here or the 600 Thermal X hub shelter that's set up right next to me, is opening the windows and drying them out. I just pulled this window open and there's some moisture in this corner of that one window. The window flaps, the coverings, can trap a little bit of moisture back behind there, and that will be slower to dry out than the rest of the shelter. Next thing I'll do is I'll take a rag with some 100% silicone spray on it and I'll wipe down all my poles, all the slides for the seats, make them slide nice and smooth again. And then I'll take a set of wrenches or sockets and I'll retighten all of the bolts. Every bolt in my shelter, whether it's on the seats or on the pole hinges, get everything tightened down so it's all ready to go. And then once everything is good and dried out, I will fold this all up like normal and put it away in my snowmobile trailer. So once my shelters are set up and they're airing out and drying out, I'll have plenty of other small stuff to do. Depending on how much gear you have, there's gonna be a lot of little things that you can do. The reason that I do a lot of the maintenance that I'm about to describe is to make sure that my gear lasts as long as it can, stays in the best working condition that it can, and it makes my life so much easier when the next season rolls around and everything is pretty much ready to go. Now, rods often have a lot of moisture in the line when you put them away. You don't want to just throw them in your rod bag and throw them in storage because there's some moisture that's trapped in these cases and they could corrode. Now, me personally, I change out all the line on my reels every year. So the next thing I'll do is I'll take all these rods out, I'll pull all the line off the reels, and I'll loosen the drags, and it gives everything a chance to dry out really well. Because what happens with the moisture that's trapped on these spools is it can cause corrosion on your spools, and then the line doesn't come off the spools as well. So a good idea to get your line off if you're gonna change your line, which I recommend, and let everything dry out, and then they'll be ready to re-spool next year, and then you can just rock and roll. I have a lot of rods, so it takes me a long time to deal with all my rods. Tip-ups is an often forgotten and neglected item. Now, these trophy thermal tip-ups from Big Tooth and Clam, they store really, really well inside of a 5 or 6 gallon bucket. I can put 5 of these inside of a 5 gallon bucket. I think I can get 6 in a 6 gallon bucket. But if you just put these away, there's water moisture in the line, and that moisture will stay inside these buckets and it will cause corrosion and rust on the little screws, and it'll just keep things from working as well. The good thing about the buckets is a lot of the water will drain off, so if there's any water in there, sometimes most of it will be sitting in the bottom of the bucket. You can dump the water out, let them air out. I actually put these away with the covers off, that way they have a chance to dry out. These also go in my snowmobile trailer with everything else. My buddy heater, that was wet when it was put away, so that's out drying off. You don't necessarily have to do that, but what's going to happen if you don't is the moisture is going to work its way under the paint and it's going to bubble the paint and cause the paint to peel off, and it'll make the surface rust, and it just doesn't look great and it gets things dirty. The rust gets on your hands and on your shelter and all that, and I'll dry out the carrying case, make sure everything's dry. I'll also take silicone, wipe down any of the metal, 100% silicone spray, just like I do on the poles in my shelter. And I'll wipe down the parts on my K-drill, parts on my drill plate, and especially the chuck on the drill that will have a tendency to rust if it's put away in any kind of a moisture or a moist area. So that's really it for the most part for me, is just to get everything dried out. Don't forget about your tackle, any ice fishing tackle. If you don't use it in the open water season, you're gonna wanna open those jig boxes up and get those dried out as well, because they will condensate inside, the moisture will stay in there, and the paint will peel off your jigs. So dry it out, clean it up, wipe things down with silicone, and then get everything put away and ready for next season. And then it's time to take the boat and get out there and catch some fish. Thanks for watching, stay safe out there, and we'll see you on the water.